Can old beer make good bread? Hello and welcome back. Today we're going to attempt to make some cheesy beer flatbread out of this old beer. As you can see, this is empty and bread has actually already been made before this point because I needed to find out simply if it worked. The good news is it did, and I'll show you how I did it in a moment. The best before on this bottle of beer was about 2 months ago, and from experience I know that this sort of beer a few months later on just isn't as good as it is fresh. So I figured, well, what can I do with it? I know, let's see if we can make some bread with it. After the success of the Elvis juice pancakes that I made a few weeks ago, I thought, well, Elvis juicing pancakes was good, but maybe the flavour could be zazzed up a bit. This is a much stronger flavoured brew, and hopefully it goes down pretty well. The recipe is crazy simple, as it's flatbread, there's no rising agent, so it's simply plain flour, some sugar, some salt, some butter, some cheese, and of course the beer. I'm going to cut now to the instruction on how I made it, and I'll join you back here in a moment to see how it turned out. Okay, so this is pretty much everything we're going to be using. Obviously flour, we've got some plain flour here. This is 3 cups worth according to the recipe, which works out about 370 grams. There is a quarter cup of sugar, which works out at 50 grams. Half a cup of butter-ish, you can use more or less, to be honest, depending on how you want to do it. 65 grams is what I'm using, and then a big handful of cheese just to add some extra taste and texture, a bit of salt for seasoning, and of course, the main event, a bottle of beer. This one is a couple of months out of date, as I said, so this is very much an experiment, but let's see how we get on. In terms of beer quantity, it's around the 330, 340 ml mark, so kind of a regular small bottle or can will do you just fine. This is a bigger bottle, so I'm gonna be using about 3/4 of it. This flour has been pre-sifted, so you definitely need to do that before you start. And all we're going to do is add all the dry ingredients into here, and then the beer, and get it all mixed together. So, starting off with the flour, we leave the butter for a moment. Let's get the sugar in there. And about half of the cheese is what I'm going to use in the mix. Salt is just to be added to taste, so I'm going to somewhere around there. And let's get that beer open. That's about 2/3 to 3/4 of that bottle, so I'm going to set the rest aside. And now we need to get on mixing this. This is coming together pretty well. Probably a good idea, if you are using a larger bottle of beer, to maybe go a little bit short on the quantity. You can always add a bit in if the texture is not quite right. To be totally honest, I don't really know what texture we're going for, but this is looking pretty good so far. I'm pretty happy with that as overall consistency. Tacky, but not dry. I'm gonna use this, which is a rubberized baking tin. Because we're not using any rising agent at all, this is not gonna rise, it's gonna be pretty much a flat bread. I am gonna use a bit of this fry light just to ensure nothing sticks too badly. But I think really you could rub some olive oil or rapeseed oil or anything around, sunflower oil, whatever, in there if you wanted to. First thing is to get this mixture into this dish. I'll be honest, it smells pretty good. Now we've got our mixture into the baking pan, I'm going to put the rest of our cheese on top as kind of a decoration and cheesy crust kind of situation. And if you're thinking I've forgotten the butter, I have not. I'm going to go and heat this up in the microwave now and pour it over the top of the mixture to get a nice crusty loaf effect. Okay, that's been in the microwave for about 30 to 40 seconds. I'm just going to gently stir it in the container, try and melt down those last few pieces. And put that last bit that won't quite go just on the middle, because that will all obviously melt downwards as it bakes, as it cooks in the oven. And for the rest of it, just simply let's drizzle this over the top evenly across the whole bread. So the oven has been preheated to about 195 Celsius, which is about 375 Fahrenheit. I'm going to pop it in there for about an hour, and we'll check on it periodically to see how we're getting on. Alexa, set a timer for 1 hour.
1 hour, starting now.
While that's in the oven, we'll just take a minute to talk about the beer that we're using. It's a 99 Red Baboons from Blue Monkey Brewery. It's a dark ruby ale. Now, as I said, it's a couple of months out of date. This is quite a strong tasting brew anyway. The aging will only make that stronger, but I think for the bread, that will work wonders, because having experimented a bit before with IPAs in pancakes and that sort of thing, I know that the taste sometimes gets a little bit lost when cooked. I'm hoping the fact that this may be beyond its best might actually be in our favour this time. It is described as a dark and interesting ale combining fruity hoppiness with a dark malty side. Is it a porter? Is it a mild? You decide. But it's one of my favourites, and annoyingly, I left this at the back of the cupboard without realising for a bit too long, and, well, it's gone its best. So, let's see if it's any good today. So I've just taken the bread out of the oven after exactly 1 hour. As you can see, it's not really risen. It's possibly a little overdone on top, but only just. There's still a bit of the butter that we poured on top sizzling around the side, so I'm going to get this out of here, pop it onto the wire rack, and let it cool for kind of 15 to 20 minutes, and then we'll give it a try. So here it is. Look at the crust on that. I said a moment ago, this was left in for exactly an hour. I think a few minutes earlier might have been better, but to be honest, now it's settled a bit, it doesn't really look overly done at all, just a few nice crispy cheese bits on the top. It smells absolutely lovely. It's still warm, but not hot. So let's see what happens. It's got a nice thick crust on it, and it's still steaming away. Check that out. It smells like bread. I'm not getting a lot of the beer on the smell. Consistency, I mean, it is a flatbread, so it's quite dense. Ooh. Hello. If you ever tried to make bread in like a bread maker or something, it's not gone quite right and it's not risen properly. It has, visually it has that kind of slightly spongy texture, but actually when eating it, it's not kind of anywhere near as disappointing as that. It's got quite a nice, it's got quite a nice soft bite. The beer is coming through in the bread. It makes it a lot richer. And those little bits of cheese in there just help lift everything all the way through. It's got a serious crusty crunch on it. If you want to have a sophisticated night on the beers and want something a little bit fancy to go with it, this is where it's at. Got no butter on here, no nothing, because there's all the butter in the crust. It's just, those cheesy bits on top are amazing. I would be really interested to try this with all the proper ingredients for a proper risen loaf. I think it'd work really well. But as a minimal ingredient flatbread, it is really delicious. Initially, I thought the texture was going to be that kind of bread gone wrong, spongy vibe, but it's actually more cakey. It's almost like a savoury beer and cheese cake. Oh, that's really good. The great thing about this is, of course, there's thousands of different variations you could do. Different cheeses, a few different herbs, spices, get some chili in there, and obviously endless possibilities on the beer front as well. I'm glad to report, if you do ever find yourself with a nice beer that's gone a few months out of date, maybe don't drink it, get it in a loaf instead, because that is absolutely divine. If you do decide to have a crack at this yourself, please let me know how it goes in the comments below. And if there's any variations on this you'd like to see me do, I'd really like to hear them. That's everything for this video. I hope you have a fantastic day. Please like this video if you haven't already. Subscribe if you would be so kind, and I'll catch you next time. Cheers.